to put one in the mood for Christmas.
To take places without which I can be coming here every day.
Whenever any of my brother or sister asked me how about VI, I told him, if you come to VI, you will see if you are in New York.
So,
both from
to have for Christmas and still live in the that means that Christmas to us all. Christmas.
I don't play. Money will come. Just hold on. Let's be sure to celebrate the reason for the season, which is love.
There is my child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day.
All hands are on deck to set the ball rolling. Destination, IDP's camp calls and droves they storm this camp. The joy and excitement at the camp as they receive their visitors with assorted gifts.
One day I wake up, I come to school, I did not eat. But today they are bringing food to us. We are saying thank you, I'm joyful.
This is what makes us to feel that we are still Nigerian. We have hope that we can make it. If we see people are coming into our help in this way.
One day he will eat food, but it's not enough food we are facing.
The visitors are also delighted to have such an experience.
Even though we can't help the whole world, but at least we can make a difference.
So I thank God that I'm privileged to be part of people who are giving.
To stay united and always give out things that we're not using or we can buy things for them.
Share your stuff with all fans.
I'm so happy to be here and like help and like reach out and know that I have accomplished something.
The message from Pesada's schools is we should all be one another's in our country, within our communities. The times are getting tougher, but the saying that goes, when the going gets tough, let the tough get going.
This is what Nigeria is all about. But the haves must assist the have-nots. We are one Nigerian, irrespective of your background, religion, race, color, education.
They even change gear to another level. An evening of love and performances. Recitation, renditions, choreography, and pageant for both boys and girls.
Education because it is very important.
Every Muslim must show goodness and mercy to his parents throughout their life.
Let's follow after me. Yeah.
Dedicated, committed to their jobs. The students are highly disciplined and the learning environment is conducive.
Heard what the children have said. You find what they preach. They're preaching unity, they're preaching progress, they're preaching diversity.
The grand finale, featuring Paysetters Gwarimpa, Wuse, and Guzape, is always a thriller.
Man, enjoy every bit of the party.
Ha-ila, ha-ila-la, Muhammad Rasulullah. Ol-Balawa, Kabon.
But don't kill any of our artists, Zigro.
Wow, it's sure a sight to behold. Very colorful, with all the fun games you can think of.
Access the Quran. All you who believe, stand out fearing for justice.
Is what we've got here. The grand entry of Masters and Mrs. Pace Setters. Dances and renditions. The mommies and daddies could no longer resist the appeal of the inviting rhythms and melodies.
They have brought everybody together, the parents together with the children, and the program they presented is really very, very encouraging.
A lot of calisthenics displays by the children. It's a lovely place to be, and we're always here at the same time at the end of the year.
It's a means of teaching our children to love, to care, and also to share.
It has been a very rewarding time, and it has been a successful one indeed.
The climax featuring raffle draws, happy hour, and presentation of prizes again gave almost everyone something to remember for a long time.
That was highly entertaining. Those kids have got talent. Next up, it was the vigilance of the people of Otuogidi in Ogbia local government area of Bayelsa State that enabled the arrest of two alleged kidnappers. Ebinimi Zitimiyi reports that youths of the community worked closely with security agents to effect the crackdown that saw the release of three female victims, all students of the College of Health Technology, Otuogidi.
The students were said to have been kidnapped by gunmen around 11 a.m. Monday 2nd December 2019 near the school, leaving other students in disarray.
Some of our students are off-campus students. They were returning and getting to one or two Gidi junction close by. The incident occurred.
A divisional police officer quickly mobilized policemen and local vigilante to the scene where they supposedly escaped from. And later that evening, we were able to recover 9 horsepower boats, and we recovered some food items most likely belonging to the kidnappers.
It was gathered that before the abductors could salvage any booty from their crime, the local vigilante and other concerned youths of Ogbia Kingdom followed a tip-off from locals engaged in farming and fishing activities along the creeks and apprehended the kidnappers.
We made other moves on how to reach out to them. That was when the Ogbia vigilante also come and met us there. We advanced into the forest, and to God be the glory, we saw the girls and also apprehended the kidnappers.
An angry mob set ablaze the two kidnapped suspects.
And the policemen that were at the scene and the local vigilante were not heavily armed. They overpowered the policemen and started beating those suspects. Before they could call for reinforcement, they community people and some thugs were able to kill those suspects.
Two police officers that were stationed to secure the College of Health Technology Otuogidi were recently ambushed and killed, and their guns allegedly stolen. The subsequent kidnap of the three female final year environmental health students must have triggered the jungle justice method on the suspected hoodlums.
We don't normally encourage people taking laws into their hands when they assist in arresting suspects. Be that as it may, we are still investigating.
The town recently stepped up vigilante activities to safeguard the community from criminal elements.
Well, like they say, it takes a village. However, jungle justice should not be the final option. We like to see on this program that physically challenged people are not disabled, proving each time we feature them. Anna Daniels, who was with some individuals in this category, reports that discrimination has remained a challenge for them. However, those who are determined to actualize their aspirations dare to surmount them.
Are found in street corners, most times asking for alms from passers-by. Most of them say they resorted to street begging because they do not have the prerequisite to secure a good job or pursue their dreams. However, there are other people with disability who are leaving nothing to chance to ensure their rights are respected. For instance, Susan Ihoma is disabled but has all it takes to earn a living, yet she is denied employment.
I'm a graduate. I have an OND in computer science. I have a BSc in education. I have a PG in genetic counseling. I speak the three major languages, which also is what the grassroots need because they love languages where they communicate.
Like Susan, other persons with disabilities have come together on this roof to speak out against the ill treatment meted on them by this society.
Tell my friends of my dreams. If I talk like this, they will be like, some of them will try to let me remember that there is a situation with me.
They thought the albinos are not able to perform as or other people. I have a good result. But when I went for employment, I'll be interviewed and they will say, we'll see you later. That's the end.
Section 1 of the Discrimination Against Persons with Disabilities Act criminalizes all forms of discrimination against persons with disabilities. If you are caught, the fine ranges from 100,000 to 1 million, depending where you belong, either as a private individual or as a corporate organization. Therefore, no Nigerian shall be discriminated on the grounds of disability, no matter the circumstances.
And if you ask me, ability is a thing of the mind. Once your mind says it's capable, then your body falls in line. Let's give people living with disability the rights that who knows who next will become disabled. Remember, no one sees tomorrow.
I dream to become the governor of my state later in the future.
Watching them, I hope you were motivated to do more with your talents. Now, with an aim to harness the potential in the tourism sector towards entertainment, and revenue generation, stakeholders converged on Lagos for the Destination Tourism Night to discuss the way forward. Uzezi Arure reports.
Tourism, arts and crafts are some of the parameters used to determine the nation's cultural heritage. Over here in Lagos is a discourse on entertainment and tourism have been able to help the nation's GDP and create jobs.
The United Nations World Tourism Organization, UNWTO, states that tourism is the highest employer of labor, as well as it serves the society. The 2019 Tourism Night attracts tourism agents, tour operators, government agencies, as well as investors who converge ecotourism across the
country. There are fantastic places, tourist sites,
can't find anyone. Of no return is there. The slave routes are there. The four-story building in Nigeria, and name it. Then when you go to Obudu in Calabar, when you go to Kogosi, you know, fantastic thing, you know, hot and cold water.
If we make an effort to conceptualize what we want our areas to be like and draw people to come in there.
The organizer, Ayo Omotosho, implored Nigerians, especially youths, to take advantage of the business opportunities tourism brings.
All other sectors that have to do with tourism must come under one umbrella. A lot of people will say, yes, we have infrastructural problems. Yes, we do. But more importantly, if we could revisit the Presidential Council on Tourism, it will go a long way.
Was the aim of maximizing destination marketing and generate revenue streams now that government is looking at various options to oil? Former governor of Cross River State, Donatuk, says tourism can boost the nation's GDP as well as develop major areas of the economy.
It could be water, it could be financial, it could be medical, it could be education. But the important thing is get people moving.
Destination Tourism Night is a hub of unrivaled networking opportunities for tourism viable countries in a friendly atmosphere.
Now we can boldly say that the future of tourism in Nigeria is looking good. Time for a break. Newsline will return after these messages. Welcome back. 4 decades ago, the Ahmadu Bello University played host to a good number of young minds with great academic success. Upon graduation, everyone prays to continue in their aspirations. They have gathered again from far and near to take stock of climates and chart a way forward. Omenka Amorachukwu captured the colorful event.
Call it homecoming, you'll not be wrong. These faces are familiar to each other. The journey of life may have set each and every one of them on different pathways. If it's not a speech-making event, rather it's and graduating exchange of pleasantries is over. Now to the real deal, focusing on the major reasons for the gathering. The record number of projects embarked upon, especially those that promote students' welfare and the community the school is situated.
I keep telling our colleagues, the sky is slowly getting darker. You know, there is something you can't buy with money that is seeing your colleagues. The memory you share 40 years to date, you can buy it in the market.
I didn't even know of the existence of the group till 2 years ago. So when I joined the group, many things have happened. Helping each other, being good to the society, and then ultimately being honored today. So I
have a classmate of mine who is now a federal permanent secretary. I haven't seen her for the past 38 years. Since we graduated, we ran the same course. I didn't see her until today. We thank Almighty Allah for the gift of long life.
The Baziko class of 77-78 is proud to have members who have contributed meaningfully to the growth and development of the nation.
Elsewhere, in recognition of his many achievements in River State, Ogbako Ekwere Cultural Organization Worldwide has honored Governor Iyesan Wike with a chieftaincy title, Dike Oha Ekwere. Ogechi Iyekwere reports that the title was conferred on the governor at a civic reception held in his honor by the Ogbako Ekwere, an apex social cultural organization of the Ekwere ethnic nationality.
Ike in his political career has earned many titles and honors, but no one has excited him like the latest chieftaincy title bestowed on him as the Dike Oha by his people, the Obako Ikwere Cultural Organization Worldwide, meaning the strong man of Ikwere. Wike seen as a strong man in Nigerian politics has left his prints on the sands of time. Right from when he was the Obiakpo Council Chairman, Chief of Staff, Government House, Minister of State for Education, Supervising Minister of Education, and now a two-time Governor of River State. Testimonials came about the sterling qualities of Governor Wike and his unquenching zeal for development.
We are satisfied that he has performed superlatively very well.
His Excellency invested heavily in the provision of infrastructure and human capital development.
If someone who has not failed to speak when the people are oppressed,
we are here to celebrate the giant strides that you have carried out through infrastructural development and human development.
Since the prophet has no honor among his people, but your people are honoring you, celebrating you, appreciating you, they are applying for more.
I can say that you have performed in a way that I doubt any future or past governor can compete with you.
The governor of River State does not discriminate non-indigene. We are always fully involved.
You deserve this honor, Governor Wike. You deserve more.
The civic reception also goes to tell how detribalized Governor Wike is as cultural troops coming across other states and tribes were on ground to spice up the events. Governor Wike used the occasion to appreciate all those who have contributed to his achievements and tasked the Ikwere ethnic nationality to work in unity with the other tribes to move the state forward. He also recognized the fact that he couldn't have attained the height of success thus far without the support of his beautiful better half.
We have Ikwere people that have no democracy in our marriage. We are in charge. The one who has led me to seek opinion. We should have the power at the moment.
A true reflection of a lover of unity, peace and development, the latest chieftaincy title holder in Ikwere land, Governor Nyesom Wike, a.k.a. Mr. Projects.
Congratulations to Governor Wike on the recognition. Lack of compliance to the enrollment of state workers in the federal pension scheme has been identified as major constraints to pension administration in the country. The chairman, Senate Committee on Establishment and Public Service, Senator Ibrahim Shekarau, made this known at a three-day retreat organized by Pension Funds Administrators of Nigeria held in Uyo. Kelvin Samuel.
Possible to see that most of the issues raised are properly addressed, says it is not palatable for any government to deny pensioners their rights.
What we have resolved to do is to bring this to their attention and take it up with all the relevant quarters. It's one thing to have the law in place, it's another thing to get it implemented. And we've discovered most of the problem is in the implementation and complying with the provision of the Pension Act.
We believe the intervention of the both chambers of the National Assembly is going to achieve the solution to this crisis, because most of the pensioners are not getting their dues as at when due. And
key stakeholders expressed optimism that the retreat will help in enhancing the compliance of National Pension Commission, especially as regards prompt payment of benefits to pensioners.
The CPS in the last 15 years have made appreciable progress in addressing most of the shortfalls of this SYL pension schemes. As of 30th September 2019, the pension industry membership had grown to 8.85 million participants.
The scheme has come of age. It's been around for over 14 years now. It works. It's effective, but there's still a lot to be done to make it more efficient.
Proposed changes as requested by pension fund operators include timely redemption of accrued right bond, implementation of new contribution rates for public sector employees, and payment of arrears. The retreat featured presentation of papers on pension industry, the way forward, operations of contributory pension in Nigeria. Several vital contributions were made.
Next, another consumer food product on the tables of Crown Flour Mills Limited, makers of Olam grains, has been introduced into the Nigerian commodity market. It is the Crown Pasta. The product was officially launched in Abuja.
A flour mill company, Crown Flour Mill, has introduced a new food variety into the market. The new product, Crown Slim Spaghetti, was unveiled in the presence of the company's numerous members of staff, distributors, and marketers across the country.
What the consumer really needs, we've studied the consumer quite a bit, the Nigerian consumer in various cities. What they want is a great pasta, but at an affordable price. When they talk about a great pasta, it means the right strand size, it means a non-sticky tasty product, and it means a product that can go with any sauce. We are also providing vitamins and micronutrients for nutrition. That's the essence of a good pasta, but at a good price.
The attempt here today is actually to add another baby to the food basket. A lot of Nigerians are very familiar with pasta. We're talking about macaroni, spaghetti in different shapes and sizes. We have actually brought to the table another variety, because Nigerians need to have choices.
Organizers of the event say the new brand stands out among other products in the market, which is set to take over the Nigerian food industry.
We expect the products to be heavily available across all the trade channels in Nigeria.
We have a lot of marketing support that are planned for this brand to ensure that we gain awareness and we gain a trial generation by the consumers in a very short time. And we are confident that once consumers are buying this product, when they are eating this product, they will love it because it's a very good and great product.
The event had fascinating dance presentations from various parts of the country. Crown Flour Mill prides itself as the largest player in the flour milling industry and has recently acquired Dangote Flour Mill. The company is also a subsidiary of Olam International, a company which deals in food and agriculture across many countries of the world.
Still on corporate stories, a vital foam distributor from Maiduguri, Alhaji Idi Mohammed Anka, has emerged the overall winner of the 2019 Vitafoam National Distributors Award. He was honored at the grand finale of the awards in Lagos. Imole Ayotunde reports that winners represented fabulous prizes.
Idi Mohammed Anka, who is the CEO MIM Anka Enterprise, was rewarded with a Mercedes 1117 truck. The second best national distributor, Alhaji Lawan Muhammad, also clinched a Mercedes 1114 truck. Chidiebere Oti, the CEO of Canopy Global, won the prize for the third best national distributor as well as a dealer with the highest premium product patronage. He carted away a Mercedes 814 truck,
and a refrigerator. UE Obi Nigeria Enterprise backed the award for the dealer with the highest percentage in volume. She was rewarded with a refrigerator. All the winners are to enjoy an all-expenses-paid trip to Dubai.
He who is standing is afraid of falling down. Who is falling down already is down. So somebody standing is afraid of falling down. So we strike and we pray hard to make sure we keep the tempo.
We've been counted, we've been recognized, and it shows that hard work pays.
I think this will spur me more, or spur us more as a company to do more better in our enterprises, in our company.
The group managing director, Vitaform Nigeria PLC, Taiwo Adeniyi, said the awards is geared towards promoting a healthy competition among distributors and appreciate them for their contribution towards the growth of Vitaform.
These are distributors who have been with us even when we had it very rough. I mean, talk of 2016, 2017, they didn't change their trade. They remained with us. And so today, we are glad to reward them for doing that.
Our customer base keep improving, and their performance per year keep improving. Even in the north, with the difficulties of security, they are still trying their best.
Vitaform Nigeria PLC, a leading manufacturer of flexible and rigid foam products, reassures its customers of quality, innovative and customized products to constantly meet their needs.
Congratulations to those hard-working distributors. It's good to know that you're still... Welcome back. The federal government in May this year granted Belema Pipeline Limited approval for oil exploration in Kula, a Kukutoru local government area of Rivers State. The company has successfully relocated residents of a Yoluro operational base of oil mining lease. Let's hear the rest of the report from Jani Kume Ololo.
The owners of Robert Curie, the operational base of Belema Oil Producing Company Limited, recently relocated from the area to pave way for the development of the Belema Industrial Island. The mega project has provision for the construction of a tank farm, gas plant industrial estate, pipe coating plant, and helipad, as well as other facilities that will feed the Belema Oil Terminal at Kula. In line with the terms of agreement, the company has paid compensation to the residents.
I'm thanking Belema Pipeline for its greater support you have given to Robert Curie to carry us out of this place. He have paid us better money.
Belema Oil is the man that God sent from Kola.
The relocated residents of Robert Curie admit that the development comes at a cost, even as they look forward to benefiting from the over 10,000 jobs to be created when the Belema terminal becomes fully operational.
We are not forced to move away from this place because we take time to come and take enumeration of the people one after the other, seek their consent, they are accepted, and we have to give them the money. Cash, fabulous amount.
We believe that if this place becomes an industrial city, it's going to provide a lot of benefits that will accrue to the people.
According to Director of Belema Pipeline Limited, Engineer Mufa Willish, the compensation of relocated residents is a true reflection of Belema Oil's unique brand of corporate social responsibility and community relations.
We have come today still in the appreciation mood to tell them that we are grateful for the peaceful exodus from this place.
The Indigenous Exploration and Production Company says it is determined to continue to positively affect the lives of its host communities as well as other parts of the country that are equally in need of development. It also expresses its profound gratitude to the government of President Muhammadu Buhari for approving the establishment of Belema Oil Terminal, Kola, which it considers a major investment that will improve the loss of Niger Delta when it comes on stream in no distant time.
To So safety matters now. Anyone riding a motorcycle without rear view mirrors probably has a death wish, considering how vulnerable cyclists are when meandering through busy routes, competing with automobile for space. Now, using Makurdi, the Benue State capital, as case study, Sandra Dowuse Akeme examines the dangers and repercussions of disregarding this road safety requirement.
Motorcycles, particularly in Makurdi, the state capital, may be peculiar, being that these cyclists prefer to ride without side mirrors. Does it mean these motorcycles come without the accessories?
According to a dealer, motorcycle mirrors are different and vary from manufacturer model to the type and style of motorcycle.
Every motorcycle you see here carries side mirrors. Each of every motorcycle and any customer that came to buy, we give them side mirrors.
Experienced personalities have averred that motorcycle rear view mirrors are very useful for spotting potential hazards that, if not noticed, may lead to serious damage on both cyclists or their passengers. This is largely due to the fact that on a motorcycle, life is much at risk of unpleasant situations such as crashes. Motorcyclists, however, have their reasons for riding without mirrors.
Our machine, the sign will not be big. So before you look inside sign mirror, maybe that's a few colors then, a few four.
General Secretary Benue State Motorcycle Association Makurdi Branch Innocent Anyebe says the rearview mirror is an integral part of vehicles and motorcycles as it helps cyclists to monitor traffic for precautionary measures.
Very important. So what we are using this media or this opportunity to also advise the general public, especially those that climb the kick machine from one place to another, to ensure or to see that the rider, the machine they are to climb, has a side mirror.
The Deputy Commander Operations Federal Road Safety Corps, Solomon Aguri, noted that mirrors provide various types of information and are important for risk management by riders. He says it is illegal to ride without rear view mirrors.
Riding motorcycle without side mirror is an offense and it's a hazard. It's a hazard to the rider because you won't know what is coming behind you. Even if you want to turn, you must bend your neck to look behind. On our path, we are educating them. We are also not just educating, we are arresting them.
He further says that if riders adhere strictly to its use, ghastly and fatal incidences will be reduced on the roads.
Takes is enforcement and the riders will fall in line. It's time for our last break. Stay with us.
To the Government of the Federation, Boss Mustafa, on behalf of the government and people of Nigeria, in conjunction with Ekaete family, regret to announce the death of late Chief Ufot Joseph Ekaete, retired Federal Permanent Secretary, former Secretary to the Government of the Federation, and pioneer Minister of Niger Delta Affairs, who passed on to glory on 25th September 2019 at the age of 80. Activities lined up for the funeral are as follows. Service of songs and night of tributes, date Monday 9th December 2019, Venue International Conference Center, Area 10, Garki, Abuja, time 5 p.m. You are cordially invited. Announcer, Boss Mustafa, Secretary to the Government of the Federation.
2019 service of nine lessons appears to have come early this year with the Radio Nigeria NTA Vaughan Choir treating Nigerians and the world to the annual lesson carols. Victor Azu report.
Ambience already betrays the occasion. The procession with the choirs only information. It's the combined annual service of nine lessons and carols of Radio Nigeria, NTA and Voice of Nigeria. Graced top government functionaries, traditional rulers, among them renowned professor of music, Lazi Kweme, and clergymen. The stories of the fall of humanity, the promise of the Messiah, and the birth of Jesus Christ is told in 9 short Bible readings, which may have influenced the messages from the dignitaries.
As a nation, we have every reason to be thankful for God's mercies. Things are changing, things are improving. We are not there yet, but we have taken a step.
In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen.
As the Christmas light comes on and carols sounding out from the various choirs and soloists, some may need a reality check that it's only the first day in December. Indeed, Christmas has arrived early this year. And with the theme, Jesus in the midst of the storm, the Christmas message calls on Nigerians to return to God for solutions to all the nation's challenges.
Never talk down on the country. There is hope for the full restoration. Where other countries will be looking for Nigerian passports.
This service of 9 lessons and carols was started over 15 years ago in Enugu by the Radio Nigeria Choir.
Another beautiful festival of 9 lessons there. I hope you enjoyed watching. It was a celebration of life as family, friends and colleagues of late Ghania Yetunde Elias gathered to bid her farewell at an Islamic funeral in Lagos. Imolayo today reports.
It is stated in the Holy Quran that verily every living soul shall taste. That is the case of Ghaniyat Yetunde Elias, who passed on to eternal glory, leaving behind a wonderful family who are proud of the legacies she left behind. The late Ghaniyat Yetunde Elias worked at Post and Telecommunication Services at Racecourse in Lagos until 1954. When she proceeded to the UK to study law, she was admitted to the Society of the Inner Temple, a professional association for barristers and judges, upon a call to the English Bar in 1959. She became a magistrate in Lagos for a short time before leaving a career to focus on caring for her family.
She was a very matriarch, but above all, a very kind, very gentle person.
Ghaniyat Yetunde Elias was married to Chief Justice Taslim Olawale Elias, an Attorney General and President of International Court of Justice in 1959, until he passed away in 1991.
Very peaceful, very religious. And as far as I could remember, I never saw her in life ever angry. Very amiable, very quiet, peace-loving, peaceful.
She was very yet unobtrusive. She led a fantastic life. May the Almighty Allah accept her into Aljannah Firdaus.
The late Ghaniyat Yetunde Elias, a native of Lagos State, passed away on the 3rd of December 2019 after a brief illness. She was born on January 12, 1932. She left behind siblings, children,
her soul rests in perfect peace. Amen. Had fun tonight? I'm sure you did. Do keep a date with us next week.